Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today let me show you 10 different ways to move files on your Mac. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 700 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. Now chances are when you need to move files on your Mac, you use one method to do so. But there are actually a whole bunch of different ways to move files. Some of those are good for some situations and some are good for other situations. So let's start off with the most straightforward method. That is to simply drag and drop between two windows. So here I have some files in a folder and I want to move a file from one folder to another. I can go to File, New Finder Window, and I've got a second Finder window open. Let's resize that so I can put it next to this window so I can see them both side by side. Now let's go to the folder that I want to move the file to, so maybe in this folder here. Then I simply drag and drop from one window to another to move the file from one folder to the other folder. But let's say I want to move this file to a folder that I can see here in the other window, like I want to move this file to this folder. I don't need a second window for that. I can simply take this file and drop it in there. But let's say it's a little more complex than that. Let's say I don't want to move it into this folder, but I want to move it into a subfolder here. In this view I can do just what I did. I can drag and drop that directly into that subfolder by simply opening up this folder here. But I could also use spring-loaded folders for this. So I drag this document here, I hover over this folder and wait for a couple of seconds, and then it will open up. That's called spring-loading. Now I can see the contents inside of here and I can drag and drop into this folder. The preferences for spring loading can be found in System Preferences under Accessibility and then Pointer Control, and then you see Spring Loaded Delay. You can turn it on or off and you could set it from short to long or somewhere in the middle. Now regardless of where you have it set, spring loading can be sped up by using the spacebar. So I could drag over to temp and as soon as I'm over it hit the spacebar and it immediately jumps down into that folder. Spring loading is particularly handy if you're in icon view because there's no way to view the contents of this folder without hovering over it, waiting for spring loading to activate, and then you jump down into the folder there. Now instead of having two windows open, you could use tabs. So let's expand this window a little bit, and then let's go and open up a new tab. And in this tab, I could go to another location. Now I've got the file I want to move here, and I want to move it to the folder in this tab here. I can use spring loading for this as well. Just drag over here to the tab and wait for it to load up. Then I can drop it in here. Now here are some more straightforward ways to move files. You can add folders to your favorites here on the left. All you need to do is take a folder and drag it over in there. And one reason people do that is to quickly navigate to those folders. But you can also use them as a way to drop files. So I can take a file like this and drop it into one of these folders here without ever having to actually view the destination. This is something I use every day. Likewise, if you have a folder you're commonly moving things to, you can drag and drop the folder to the right side of the dock here, drop it in, and then you can use that as a place to drop files. You drop it in there, and the file then goes into that folder. So what happens if you're in a folder and you want to move the file to a folder above it? I can command click here and see how deep I am in the folder structure. Let's say if I want to move this file up two levels. I can't, while dragging, do anything here to move up. But I can go to View and then Show Path Bar. And you'll see the full path down here below. You can drag and drop into any one of these to put it in one of the levels above the current folder. Now here's one most people, even experts, don't even know. You can use the forward and backward buttons here. So let's say I'm in a folder and I'm at this location. And then I go to another location, like here, and I decide I want to move this file to the previous folder I was looking at, no matter how I got there, whether I navigated using the sidebar or the go command or however I got from one folder to another, I can go here, go to the back button, wait, it will pop back to that previous location, and then I could drop the file there. Likewise, I could go into a location I want, let's say down into here, and then go back, I'll go back to there. I'll drag to the forward button and you can see it goes one step forward. If I move off and then back on, it'll go the second step forward and now I can drop it in there. So here's one that might work for some people. Notice how my desktop is nice and clean. I don't have any files or folders there. If you've got a nice clean desktop like this, you can use it as a temporary holding place because it's always there. You always have the desktop behind everything. So I can drag this file here temporarily, then navigate to another location, and then drag it to that place. So look at this as another reason why you might want to keep a nice clean desktop. Now if you have a location that you're commonly moving files to, you can always create a quick action to do it for you. So in Automator, create a quick action. Set it to receive files or folders in the Finder. And then look for the Move Finder Items action. Add that there. And under 2, select the location where you want the files to go. So in this case, let's say it's that Docs folder inside the Temp folder, way down in there. And then let me save this. And since it's a quick action, I'll save to the Services menu. Now I can quit Automator and I can select a file and then go to Finder, Services, and then look under Files and Folders for that. Move to Special Docs folder. Activate that and it will move it there. You can also set a keyboard shortcut for it in System Preferences. And if you're using the Preview, you'll have quick actions here. You can click on More, Customize, and add it here. And then you'll see it appears right here and I can click on it. Now here's one a lot of people know, but not everybody, and it may be the most useful technique besides the basic drag and drop, and that's to copy and move. So you could select a file like this and use Command C or Edit, Copy. Then you can go to a new location. So navigate however you want, and then go to Edit, and instead of Paste Item, which would make a copy of the file and place it here, you hold the Option key down and it changes to Move Item here. So Option Command V would do this. And this moves the file there. And I know a lot of people complain that this is the opposite of how Windows works. In Windows, you cut the file, then you move, and then you paste it in place. And on Mac, you copy the file, then you go somewhere else, and then you Option Paste to move. I like this method better because it doesn't leave the file in limbo anywhere. You don't cut it and then it's gone and then paste it somewhere. You just simply copy it. It doesn't do anything with the file. And then you can choose whether to paste or move the item. And all of these methods, including copy and paste, work for multiple files. So I'm going to use the Command key to select multiple files here. And you can see I could drag them together and use any of those dragging techniques. I can Command C to copy. I can go into a folder here and you can see I could paste the 4 items or Option and move the 4 items there. Now I want to finish with one quick note. Any of these move commands you can change to a copy command by simply holding down the Option key. So I'm going to drag and move this here, but if I hold the Option key down, notice how the cursor adds this green plus icon under it. That will make a copy of it at the current location. However, this is the opposite if you're going to another drive. So for instance, I have another drive right here called Archive. If I were to take that and move here, you can see it changes to a plus button. That means it's going to make a copy of it there. It's not going to delete it from my current drive. It's going to instead make a copy of it for the new drive. But if you want to move it there, you can hold the Command key down and you can see the green plus icon goes away. And now I'm actually moving the file. So it's really basically making a copy of the file on the new drive and at the same time deleting it from the original drive. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.